Okay, this is a video about price takers and how to make decisions given certain set of costs. So this one starts with the quantity of labor. That's interesting about this one. I have another one that starts with quantity produced, but this one is the quantity of labor and from the total product to the marginal product, and then we talk about cost, total variable, total cost, marginal cost, average variable, and average cost. And then I pick a price, the price of the product that this is producing. So how much will it sell for each unit? Well, I can pick any price here with this little gizmo. And then based on that price, I can figure out what quantity I should produce, what will be my total revenue, my total cost, and what will be my total profit. So the issue is how to maximize total profit. And the rule is you do all of the ones for which the marginal benefit, in this case marginal revenue, is greater than the marginal cost, and none for which the marginal cost exceeds the marginal revenue. So here's how it works. First, we start with quantity of labor. This is a firm. These are the costs of a firm. They hire their first unit of labor. The first unit brings them 10 units of output. Quantity produced is 10 units. That's the total product. The marginal product, that is, marginal product is the addition to the total product because you hired this next or marginal worker. So the total product increased from 0 to 10 because the quantity of labor increased from 0 to 1. So the marginal product of this first worker is 10. When you hire the second worker, the total product increases from 10 to 22. That means the marginal product of this second worker is 12 because the quantity produced increased from 10 to 22. That's a 12 unit increase because you hired the second worker. The third worker, the total product increased from 22 to 36. That's a 14 unit increase because you hired the third worker. So the marginal product always tells you how much additional output you got from an additional worker. And you'll notice that the marginal product, as you hire the first, is 10, second is 12, third is 14. That's increasing returns. Then diminishing returns starts with a fourth worker. You got 13 units of output, then 12 from the fifth, 10 from the sixth, 9 from the seventh, etc. So this is marginal product. Now, the question is, what are costs? Because our issue with making decisions is to compare the marginal benefits to the marginal costs. So we have to decide what is the price of a unit of labor. So I want to make it, I'm going to make it $100. $100 per unit of labor, that's the cost. So when you hire the first unit of labor, when you have 0 units of labor hired, you produce 0 units, you have $200 of total cost. If you're producing 0 units and you have any costs at all, those are your fixed costs, $200. And it's over here, it says the fixed costs are $200. Now you hire the first worker and, I've got this at 125, there. First worker and your total variable cost is $100. Remember, labor is your variable resource. And so when you hire one unit of labor, your total variable cost is $100. Your total cost is $300 because you have to add the fixed cost to the variable cost. You hire the second worker, your total variable cost is $200. You add the fixed cost to that, and your total cost is $400. You hire three workers, your total variable cost is $300. Add the $200, your total cost is $500. See how this column works? This tells you the total cost of producing this quantity of goods produced. It's not the quantity of labor. It's the total cost of producing this quantity. Quantity produced. Now, marginal costs asks a different question. It asks, because you produced one more unit, how much did your total cost increase? Well, here we produce 0 when we have 0 units of labor, and then we hire the first worker and we have 10 units of labor, 10 units produced, So how much did each of these 10 units cost us? And the answer is our total cost increased from 200 to 300 because the quantity we produced increased from 0 to 10. So marginal cost is equal to the change in the total cost, that's $100 here, divided by the change in the quantity produced, which is 10. So 100 divided by 10 is $10. Oops, that's the marginal cost, $10. Then, when we hire the second worker, our production increases from 10 to 12, and our total cost increases from 300 to 400. So marginal cost is the change in the total cost because of the change in the quantity produced. So the change in the total cost is $100. The change in the quantity produced is 12. 100 divided by 12 is 8.333. What is the marginal cost of each of these next batch? So if we increase production from 22 to 36, that's a 14 unit increase because we hired the third worker. The total cost increased by $100. So 100 divided by 14 is 7.1. So our marginal cost, dinkity, 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 dink. Now, average variable cost, remember, the average anything, you take the total anything and divide it by the quantity of anything. And just as a reminder, marginal cost is the change in the quantity divided by, the change in the total anything, in this case, total product, divided by the change in the quantity of anything, in this case, quantity produced. I'm sorry, I've screwed this up. It's the change in the total cost divided by the change in the quantity produced. That's marginal cost. Average variable cost, you take the total variable cost and divide it by quantity. So 100 divided by 10 is $10, average variable cost for each one. To get the average variable cost, when you produce 22 units, you take the total cost of 22 units, that's 400, and you divide it by quantity, which is 22. And that gives you $9.1 average variable cost for each unit. And finally, average total cost. To get average total cost, you take the total cost of producing this quantity, whatever it is, 10 units in this case, you take the total cost, $300, and divide it by quantity, 10. So your average cost is $30 per unit. To get the average cost when you produce 22 units, you take the total cost, 400, and divide it by 22. So that's this column. Okay, we've got all our costs. Total revenue, you recall, is price times quantity. Marginal revenue is the change in total revenue because you produce and sell one more unit. But this guy is a price taker, and what that means is that every additional unit they sell, they're going to get whatever the price is, in this case, $21. So their marginal revenue will be $21. So our rule is you produce the quantity. As long as the marginal revenue, 21, exceeds the marginal cost, you do it. So 21 exceeds 10, 21 exceeds 8.3, 21 exceeds... All of these units add more to the benefits than to the cost, and so your total profit is increasing. And this goes on and on. You hire an additional worker, your marginal cost of each of these units that this ninth worker produces is $14.30, and you're getting $21, so you produce it. You hire this next worker, you get 100 total units, marginal product of 5. The marginal cost of each of these 5 is $20, and your marginal revenue is 21, so you do it. And then, should you hire the 11th worker and produce 104 units? No, I don't think so, because the marginal cost of each of these 4 units is $25, and you're only going to get 21 for it. So you won't hire the 11th worker, you won't produce $104, you will stop at 10 workers, produce 100 units, and your total revenue will be 100 units times $21. That's price times quantity. So your total revenue is 2100. You subtract the total cost, which is given here in the total cost column, $1,200. So you take 2100, subtract the 1200, and look, that's the profit, $900. That's economic profit. After all costs, implicit and explicit, including a normal profit, have been paid. Nobody can go any place else and do any better. And that's just when your normal costs are paid. You got $900 profit, economic profit on top of that. So that's great. You produce, you earn your $900 and so forth. But it turns out that sadly, this price changes in the market according to supply and demand conditions. And so let's make the price $18. I just picked one. So your marginal revenue is now $18 because every time you produce an additional unit, your total revenue goes up by $18. And as long as the marginal revenue, 18, exceeds the marginal cost, you just keep producing, you keep producing, you keep producing. Oh, you'll hire the ninth worker and produce 95 units, and your marginal revenue, 18, exceeds the marginal cost. You won't produce the next batch. You won't hire the 10th worker and produce 100 units because your marginal cost is $20 and your marginal revenue is only 18. So this is the quantity you'll produce, 95 units. So what's your total revenue? It's 95 times $18, and that should work out to $1710. And your total cost is $1,100. That's given right there in the total cost column. So your total profit is $610. And this calculates the total profit of producing each of these units. So this is the maximum total profit. Anyway, it keeps going, and now the price keeps going down, 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 down. Oh my, let's go back up for a second. There. Okay, see this? This is very interesting. Marginal revenue, price is 12, so marginal revenue, this is a price taker, is 12. And let's see, you'll do that one, that one, that one, that one, because this is the marginal cost, and as long as 12, the marginal revenue exceeds the marginal cost, to keep producing. Now, you won't produce this batch. You won't hire the eighth worker. You won't produce 88 units because the marginal cost is 12.5, and your marginal revenue is only 12. So you will hire 7 workers, produce 80 units, and your marginal cost is 11. So if you're going to produce 80 units and sell them for $12, your total revenue is $960. You're hiring 7 workers. You're producing 80 units. Yeah. 80 times 12 is 960. And your total cost is $900. So you make $60. That's very nice. But what if the price goes down to 11? Ooh, look. I don't know if you can see it, but there's no output at which you will make a profit. The best you can do is lose $19. And at $11, you'll produce all of these up to 10, but the $11.10 one you won't produce. You won't produce that batch. So you'll produce that quantity, which is 71. 71 times 11 is $781. And your total cost, there's your total cost right there, is $800, you're going to lose $19. Now, will you produce and lose $19? Well, your choice is to produce zero or to produce this quantity. So which do you do? Well, if you produce this quantity, you're going to lose $19. But if you produce zero, you're going to lose $200 because your total revenue when you produce zero is zero, but your total cost is $200. So if you produce 0 units, your total loss will be $200. If you produce this quantity, you'll only lose 19. So loss minimization requires that you go ahead and produce. Now the question is, at what point will the losses be so large as the price goes down, down, down? At what point will the losses be so large that you won't produce? Well, let's try this $9 one. At $9 marginal revenue, you will produce that one, that one, that one, that one, but you won't produce that one. So you would hire 5 workers, produce 61 units. 61 times 9 is $549. And when you produce those 61 units, your total cost is $700. Your total revenue is $549, which means you lose $151. But since you lose less $151 by producing than you would by shutting down, you lose your fixed costs. If you shut down, you produce. Let's move the price to $8. And I don't know if you can see it now, but all of your total profits are negative. You lose more money by producing than you would by shutting down. The least you can lose is $208 by hiring four workers. Is it four? Let's see. Yeah, four. And total product is 49 units produced. So 49 units produced times your $8 gives you a revenue of $392, and your costs are $600. You lose $208 if you produce. You lose $200 if you shut down. So that's it. You would shut down. Now, it turns out, since I have to point this out, your average variable cost, the $8 here, doesn't cover the minimum average variable cost. So no matter what you produce, if you were to produce any of these, if you were to hire four workers, for instance, your average variable cost is $8.20, and your revenue would be only $8. So you would lose 20 cents of your variable costs and all of your fixed costs. That's why you lose more by producing than by shutting down, because the price is less than your average variable cost. So that's it. We can go through every price, and you can tell me what quantity to produce, what will be the price that is charged, what is the total revenue, total cost, total profit. And then if you're making money, that's great. If you're making zero economic profits, that's great. Okay. So if this is 11.3, okay, there. Well, we're real close. It's about zero because I need more rounding here. But whenever the price is exactly equal to the minimum point of your average cost, your profit will be zero. You'll only make normal profit, no economic profit. Anyway, these are all of the possibilities. If the price is less than your average cost, but greater than your average variable cost, you will produce at a loss. And if the price ever goes below this average variable cost, you will shut down. So I think that's it. You can play with these numbers and watch the graphs go nuts. Look at this. The graphs all go nuts. If the fixed cost changes, oddly enough, you can see the quantity you produce doesn't change. Fixed costs don't affect the quantity you produce. What they do is they affect the profits that you make. Anyway, that's it. Enough.